Hello everyone, welcome to Kartikeya IAS Academy. Let's see some articles under the PIB. The first topic is regarding the Tokyo 2020 Paralympic Games. Here we are not going to discuss about what are the games or who are going to participate. Here we'll see what is the encouragement being given to these sports person, and we'll see what are the rights or the facilities provided to the disabled people. Okay, the Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi interacted with the Indian para athlete contingent for Tokyo 2020 Paralympic Games. Okay, here this is the context in the article. Here Prime Minister interacted with those people through video conference. Okay, through video conferencing, with whom he interacted with the sportsperson, with the families, guardians, and the coaches of the athletes. Okay. In his speech, he was like discussing about how they have to be both physically and mentally strengthy. Okay, it's not just enough if they are physically strength, even they need to have mental strength. It's regarding any sports person, not just any particular kind, any sports person, they need to be both physically and mentally strong. Okay, and he has said how well they are participating in everything. He has given some encouraging words and everything. At the last, he has discussed about the rights and facilities which the government is providing to the sports person. Okay, here he has mentioned about the facilities provided to the Divyang Jan. Okay, and was treated as the welfare. So the country today is working for this as taking it as their responsibility. Okay, here the word welfare is mentioned. Here it comes under the responsibility of the country to help them in having equal opportunity with other people. Okay, though they are like, if they are disabled, even then they should be provided the equal opportunity. We had seen like in the transportation or in many other ways, we are seeing, if you see in the schools and colleges also, now they are being provided opportunities so that they can have the equal chance to lead the similar way of life like others. Okay, so here if you see, he has mentioned about one act 10 day scheme. Here it was mentioned the Rights for Persons with Disabilities Act to provide comprehensive security to the Divyangjan. Okay, and he has even mentioned about the Sugamya Bharat campaign. So now we are going to discuss about this act and this campaign. Okay, these are the examples which he has mentioned. Okay, now if you see about the rights of persons with disabilities, okay, 2016. Here, what does it say? The responsibility is on the government. Okay, on whom the responsibility is there? The responsibility is upon the government to take effective measures. Which kind of measures they have to take? They have to ensure that the people with disability also have the rights equally with others. Okay, they need to have the rights equally with others. This is what this act is all about. Okay, here it is like which kind of disability they are considering under this act. It depends on how it evolved and the like category they have divided, and this act has covering specified disabilities. Okay, they may be physical disability. Under the physical disability, again there are some subdivisions. Okay, for example, if you take the locomotor under the physical disability, okay, you may even consider as example locomotor disability. Under that, there may be, because of different reasons, there may be muscular dystrophy, there may be leprosy cured person, there may be cerebral palsy, like that. It depends on how they have got that disability. And we have discussed about the physical disability. There may be visual impairment, there may be blindness, there may be low vision. Okay, it depends on how much percentage they are having that. Okay, even hearing also, there may be disability. So there are different types which all will be included under this Act, okay, means the people who are having disability, they will be provided this rights. Okay, here who is having the responsibility? The government is having the responsibility to take the measures to provide rights equally with others. Okay, this is what we have learned, which is mentioned here. Now, if you see, what are the other policies? Okay, like what are the other things which are provided by the government? The other policies are the national policy. The national policy for persons with disability. It's in the year 2006. Okay. Now, here the persons who are having the disability will be recognized to constitute a valuable human resource for the country, because though they are disabled, even they share a majority of the population, and even they are also the valuable human resource of the country, and they even can lead a better and better quality of life, and if they are provided with equal opportunity. If they are provided equal opportunities, then they can have a better quality of life. For that reason, the government has the responsibility to take the measures. Okay. And the other thing, if you see what kind of measures are provided, you can take some examples in that. Okay. Here in the article itself, they have mentioned some examples. Which kind of things they are? If you see the sign language. Okay. For example, if we take the sign language. Now, the NCRTs are translated into the sign language so that even the people with disability will be able to use this. Okay. Generally, if we are good at that, we can easily read. But the people who have any problem, if they are translated into sign language, it will be very easy for them to access this. Okay. This is one example. Next one, we all see different kinds of facilities are provided for those people now at different transportation modes. If you take them in the train coaches, in the domestic airports, in the railway stations, infrastructure is changed. Now the infrastructure is built in accordance so that it will be helping those people. Okay. For example, as I have told you, you can see in the government buildings or in the railway stations. Okay. In the government buildings, in the railway stations, bus stations, you can see the how they are managed. Like these people also, if the people who are having disability, they should be able to access the facilities which are provided by the government. So the government has to make sure that even the people with disability are having the equal opportunity to avail all those facilities. Okay. Now this is about the national policy. In here it is the responsibility of the government to provide equal opportunity for providing them with the better quality of life. Okay. Now, here we have discussed about the policies and the rights. In the article, I have told you, they have mentioned about the Sugamya Bharat Abhiyan. So, what is this campaign all about? Sugamya Bharat Abhiyan. So, this is a nationwide campaign. This is not for a particular state, this is a nationwide campaign, and it was launched by the Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities. It was launched by the Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities. Okay, so here this department comes under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Okay, this department comes under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. To provide, why this department, where it works actually, to provide universal accessibility to persons with disabilities. Okay. Now, this Sugamya Bharat Abhiyan, it mainly focuses, where does it mainly focus? It focuses on developing accessible physical environment. Accessible physical environment. For example, which we have already discussed, like the transportation system. एंड इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम. इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम इन दीज फील्ड वी हैव सीन मेनी चेंजेस वेयर द पीपल विद डिसेबिलिटी आर इवन एबल टू अवेल देम use these facilities because they are according for example if I am not able to walk they are providing me the transportation facility where I can get on easily okay if I am not able to see or read something then they will be like you all know okay if I cannot then I can just by my touch I will be able to read what is written there if I have to get into some bus if I don't know the name of the bus if I cannot see I will be touching and I will be easily recognizing which bus it is okay so in that way the facilities are being changed so that even the people with disability will be able to access those facilities okay now we have discussed so far which is with respect to India okay now we will see at the international level we have United Nations Convention on the rights of persons with disabilities on the rights of persons with disabilities these will be very useful for you writing any essay regarding this about the social measures or the welfare schemes of the government okay so this is the United Nations convention What does it do? It is adopted by the UN General Assembly on December 13, 2006. Okay. And then it is opened for signing by the state parties on March 30, 2007. Okay. Adoption of the convention, it has really imparted empowerment to persons with disabilities across the globe. As I have told you, it is not just for a particular country, but it has provided the empowerment of persons with disabilities across the globe. For what are the main reasons? What are the things they want? It is their rights, okay? Demand their rights and make state, private and civil societies accountable for enjoying their rights. We are providing them rights, but who is responsible to make sure that they are able to utilize the facilities they are having rights? But who is the person or who is the organization? What is the organization which is responsible to make sure that they are able to enjoy the rights? It is the duty of the state, private, and even the civil societies. Okay, civil society agencies to make sure that they are able to enjoy their rights. Okay, now if you ask me, is India part of this? Yes, India also signed it. Okay, India is also part of this. Okay, now the next topic is Vriksharopan Abhiyan 2021. Vriksha, the meaning itself, you all know, it's regarding the tree. Okay, it's regarding plantation. Okay, Vriksharopan Abhiyan 2021. Here, if you see the context, during this year, coal, lignite, PSUs, public sector units of the Ministry of Coal has sent an ambitious target under the Go Greening drive. Go Greening means increasing the number of trees. Tree cover, green cover, we are increasing. We are planting more number of trees. Okay, here this drive is to cover 2,385 hectares of area under bioreclamation or plantation. Okay. When they are going to launch this? They are going to launch this on 19th August. Okay. Vriksharopan Abhiyan 2021. It is going to be launched on 19th of August by the Union Minister of Coal, Mines and Parliamentary Affairs, Sri Prahlad Joshi. Okay. Now, if you ask me, what is the need of this? Okay. What is the need? For example, see. It is expected that they are going to do more than 300 plantation sites in and around the coal fields. Okay, they are going to do the plantation in more than 300 plantation sites in and around the coal fields. Now, we all know where from we will be getting the coal and all. Okay, so if you see here, why actually we need to do this? Can we cut down the usage of coal? No. Why? Because India is not completely developed country. It is a developing country. It means our economy is still emerging. We are having an emerging economy. We are not a completely developed. So definitely we need to see the sources where we can get at lower cost. And the second thing is, which is available in our country, where the resources are available in our country, we will be selecting such an option. Okay, we will be selecting for the resources which are way which we can get at lower cost, and the other thing is which are available in our country. And if you see here, India is a developing country, all of a sudden we cannot stop using the coal and go into any other ways. Okay, so if you see here, first thing is we should stop, like more emission of carbon should be cut. Okay, so we should select, we should fulfill the commitments where we want to reduce the carbon emission. And the second thing is, even we have to use the coal, we cannot cut the uses of the coal because it is affordable. This is indigenously available, it is available in our country, and this is affordable by us, so we cannot even cut that. So here coal plays an important role in our future, because still we are emerging. Most of the countries where we need, we will be using, most of the industries we will be needing this coal, and even more coal fields and more companies which will be using coal will be sprouting up, will be increasing soon, because still we are a emerging country. Okay, now we cannot say that you shouldn't use the coal completely, and we cannot even neglect the carbon emission. We have to care about both. Okay, for that reason, what they are doing, they have adopted the policy of go green. They are going to plant more and more trees in and around the coal fields. Okay, so here this is the key initiative. The key initiative taken by the companies is go green. Okay, go greening or go green drive. Here they are planting more number of trees so that to create additional carbon sink. They cannot reduce or they cannot cut the emission of the carbon all at a time, but they can make something where it will be working as the carbon sink, so as to mitigate the causes of climate change. If you are using coal, definitely it will affect the climate, but to mitigate that, they are creating the carbon sinks by going green and planting more number of trees. Okay, here if you see, the first thing which I have told you is they are going green, and the other thing is they want to follow something like clean coal technology. They want to follow something like adopting clean coal technology, and by doing extensive plantation, by planting trees in hectares of land in and around the coal area. Okay, thank you.